Good day, my name's Don. In July 2007, I embarked on a 5-month caravan trip from Perth up to the Northern Territory. We stopped over for about a half a day in Carnarvon. Here's some pictures of Carnarvon. Traveling with my friend, a retired Scotsman, Jamie, with a 20-foot caravan pulled by a Falcon station wagon. Although the scenery between Geraldton and Northampton is very rolling and pleasant, further north it gets dead flat and boring. One of the tragic things of not having fences is the constant roadkill that we encountered on WA highways. Carnarvon is located about 600 kilometers north of Geraldton. I only had a half a day to look around in Carnarvon. I went to take a look at the 1 mile jetty located 4 miles west of Carnarvon. It was built in 1897 and is almost 1,493 meters in length. It's the longest jetty in the northwest and was once a deep sea port for the shipment of wool and local produce. The museum alongside is interesting. During the tourist season, there's a little train that carries tourists out to the end of the jetty. It seems to stretch forever. The museum has accumulated quite a bit of junk. However, there is some interesting historical information, such as the 1909 steam locomotive that operated on the Carnarvon Tramway. The Kimberley steam locomotive, built in 1921, operated during the 1950s. It's possible to clamber to the top of the original water tank used for steam-powered engines. Some of the remains at the museum in need of restoration. An old steam tractor looks forlorn. This boiler is on railway wheels. There is some technical information about some of the exhibits, such as the Ryder and Erickson hot air pumping engine. It's installed in 1911 to pump water for a homestead. Here is the engine here. Better times were in the past. Wool was a product of Carnarvon and the surrounding country, and here's an original wool wagon from the early 1900s, probably pulled by a team of bullocks. An ancient cultivator of some kind. This tractor certainly has seen better days. On the way back from the museum, we passed a swamp and lake and took these photos, looking for fish. Bananas are a major export of Carnarvon. In fact, there's a 10-meter banana constructed at the entrance to Carnarvon. Other tropical fruit are also grown, such as these mangoes. There's an immense tide at Carnarvon and a rugged sea coastline. One of the things that caught my fancy was the OTC dish, a 30-meter diameter reflector that was used during the space program to communicate with the Apollo moon mission. It's still there, but it's been retired for quite a number of years and is in disrepair. A beautiful evening and sunset on the Gascoyne River overlooking Carnarvon. Thanks for joining me, dear viewer, on this quick half-day trip through Carnarvon on my way north. I wish you a very pleasant day.